name is Kingsley Mello. I am from Chelsea, Massachusetts, and I am in the 8th grade and attend Beacon Academy in Boston, Massachusetts. I am Nigerian, and I have one brother, three sisters, and a niece. As of now, you will probably wonder why I am here, just bad on my mind. Well, I am here today to talk about a very skilled author. The author I will be speaking about is Mitali Perkins. Ms. Perkins has many interesting books, of which I read three of the summer. I enjoyed The First Daughter, White House Rules, Monsoon Summer, and The Not-So-Star-Spangled Life of Sunita Sen. Although it is viewed as out of the norm for a boy to be reading books mostly centered around girls' lives, like the ones in Ms. Perkins' books, I was in for a surprise. I found deep messages that could connect to almost anyone. Be yourself, do not get away from originality. As well as great storytelling, these messages are the ones that I think make Ms. Perkins such a great author. Ms. Perkins was born in Calcutta, India. By the age of 11, she had lived in six different places: Mexico, New York, Ghana, Cameroon, and London, before settling down in California. Books were her best friend. She could not take her friends to every village she moved to, but books she could. Books kept her grounded, even when she had to switch from her English demeanor to her Indian lifestyle. Monsoon Summer was about two twin sisters who are Indian, but live in America and go back to India for a summer visit. It changes their lives. First Daughter, White House Rules, is about a girl from Pakistan who is adopted by an American family whose father has recently won a presidential election. The Not-So-Star-Spangled Life of Sunita Sen is about a girl whose Indian grandparents visited for a while and her whole life routine is reconfigured. My favorite of Ms. Perkins' books is The Not-So-Star-Spangled Life of Sunita Sen. The main character, Sunita Sen, is stuck between two worlds and is currently trying to get out of her Indian side. In the end, she realizes authenticity is the most important thing and to never be ashamed of who she was. The reason I like this book was because of the great message it conveyed and the fact that I am part of a two-sided family also. My father is Nigerian and my mother is African-American. My father has very different traditions from my mother. For example, my father's culture has formalities that have to be covered when visitors come to your home, such as presenting a colon at gatherings. If this is not done, they will feel unwelcome and the gathering will not be recognized. Another difference in cultures is that in Nigeria, when a man and woman get married, the woman's family pays a dowry to the family of the man she is marrying. Also, children follow their father, carrying his chair for him to sit down when he wants to rest. It is hard to consistently bounce back and forth from culture to culture. Ms. Perkins is obviously a very skilled author. As an athletic, often called immature, teenage boy, she definitely caught my attention with these supposedly girly-looking books. She unwarily and subliminally has made her books unisex, even though they appear feminine to the naked eye. These stories are obviously based on girls, but the message of uniqueness runs Catholic to everyone. A message to all boys out there is to never judge a book by its cover. Just pick it up and read it. On behalf of the associates of the Boston Public Library, I would like to present this Literary Lights for Children Award to Ms. Mitali Perkins.